Hello everybody, welcome to my workbench on our project, the regulated power supply for the workbench. I will give you an update on this Zener diode. As you know, from the in part 4 I told you about it has no ring on it, so there was no way of determining the polarity of it. I managed actually to get two other Zener diodes of 100 volts, and they have a marking on it, so the problem is solved for that concerns. The only point I want to make is now the Zener diode is going to draw a lot of current that way and will probably warm up or heat up quite considerable. Now I'm thinking of making a voltage divider from two resistors. So there will be about 300 volts here. If we make a voltage divider from 30k, then we end up with a current from 10 milliamps across it. So if we divide it in 10k and 22k, what we have available, see what the tolerances will give, then we put the Zener diode parallel onto the resistor. This, then the resistor will take a lot of the current and we save a bit on heat on the Zener diode. So I want to not that it heats up too much. So that was my take on that one. So when we finish, nearly finish the project, we have put everything inside. We will do this before we put in the valves, and we will test this on 100 volts. If indeed 100 volts will occur here on that point, so the 56k will have to go. Of course, that will be a 22k with a 10k. And well, I will update the schematic, and I will tell you about it. Now, the next part is part 5. We going to put in the low voltage regulated power supply. Well, I had some thought about that, and I had some look on the internet on schematics and you name it, about everything. And well, I'm not sure about that at all. What I really want is a power supply that gives me 20-25 volts, approximately 1.5 amp, 2 amps at most, and eventually also a protection of higher current. So I had a lot of thought about that. But first things first, I will tell you, we have to put that in here. Yeah, you know, those two holes here, this is where the transformer will be. I have to re-drill that because of the fuse holder on the other side. It's goes too far inside, so it will touch on one of the contacts here, and that's not what we want. So we have to re-drill those, just the transformer moves up a bit to the front, and that will solve that problem. Next thing we want to do is to make everything float, so the minus and the plus will be from the chassis, this is not touching the chassis, so we can reverse polarity if we want to. So I had something in mind like this. Let's turn the camera a little bit. Moment. Just a moment. I'll drop them down. Sorry about that. There we go. And well, I had some thought about that. I found something that they use in transformers here. There's some insulation that we can put on in that place. We have to cut off a little bit and then make a sort of heat sink around it. So like that. So some parts sticking up, and I make a double one, so two of those. And then we have, that will be out of, 3-4 millimeters out on this side and 3-4 millimeters out of that side, and the other one close. So we have a bit of separation between them. I will get my cutting tool, I will cut some strips so that the heat can be dissipated quite easily. That's one point what I want to do. I will do that off camera, of course, because I don't think you are interested in seeing me all cutting and drilling those holes. I will do that off camera. I will get back to you, and then we fit it together and we have a chat about it. Now, going back to my project on that low voltage power supply, I had some transistors in stock for several years. The two November 3455 had a number of them in stock for years. So I was thinking, when you use transistors, and there is some current involved, there will also be a lot of heat dissipation. So I was thinking, this transistor can have up to 4 amps easily, and then it gets hot, of course. But you know where I'm going with this. I will use only a little part of the 115 watts what they are. So I'll go back to say 700 milliamps. So 700 milliamps for this one and 700 milliamps for that one. So there will be nearly no heat dissipation whatsoever, depending of course how much voltage there has to put away, but that doesn't matter. I hope that the heat dissipation will be less, so I don't have to put a big heat sink into that cabinet. So that's my thought about this. And I also have here, I have an LM317K. You can go up to 1.5 amp. So I put them on there as well. And have them on the same heatsink. Only we will insulate them from that, because we can't have that. Those can be connected on the heatsink, that doesn't matter. But this one has to be separated from that heatsink. Now, next thing I want to try is to have a Darlington setup. So they have one smaller transistor in combination with that one. So that means that the current from the 370 will be also lower, so that we save on heat on that as well. So, and for the current protection, we put one across the emitter and the base, another transistor. So if the current gets too high, then this transistor will shut that transistor down. So in worst case of a short, that will go totally blank. So nothing horrible will happen. I was considering in the beginning, put a fuse in there. And you know what the fuses do, they will go. But the transistors, they will be a bit faster than the fuse. So the transistor will be going to heaven, if it has it this way, and then the fuse will go. So to prevent that, I won't use any fuse, except on the transformer. And I will use a transistor to protect the system. So what we're going to do now next is I'm going off camera and prepare what I said, get this all done, cut this up, drill the holes, connect it all together, and then I'll come back to you, and then we fit all together, and then we fit our LM 371, I'm not so 317, yeah, and put one of the transistors up and connect them up in a Darlington fashion, with current protection, one of the old one of the two transistors, and we'll test it on the and on the power supply I have, whether he's over here. I'll show you. Then I don't need to connect up the camera. Oh, a little earthquake again. There we go. I'll switch them on. There we go. So we have voltage and current. You can see we are going up to 32 volts. So I have to connect them up here. And we can test that circuit. And if something goes wrong, we have full control over the voltage and over the current that's flowing. So we know exactly what is happening. So we can test that circuit to see how it works out. Yeah. As you say always, you have to wing it, so I have to try this. I can take and pull off a schematic or something like that, and then it's just building it, and yeah, there's nothing from yourself. So that's not what I want to do it myself. So mind you, I'm very experienced with valves, with those little parts like transistors and this that and the other. I didn't do much in my time because my interest is in valves. So all the little ICs and you know what, I didn't bother much with that. So just you have to bear in mind, if I make a mistake, that is due to that fact that I never got into that kind of subject, if you like. So what I'm going to do now is go off camera and do that, and I will come back to you. I'll see you later. Hello everybody, I'm back. I've done the necessary work, got the insulation to size and drilled the holes, and on the other I made a sort of heat sink just to cool things down. Hopefully it won't get too hot, so I need don't need anything else than that. Failing that, I always can get myself a heat sink, but it has the correct size. But there we go. Let's see how it goes. So I will now fit things together. Yeah. That way, yeah. That's how it should be. And it will fit in here like that. So, but first things first, I'm going to put the parts back in and see how it goes. Right? Turn over. Let's have a look. This one. Well, bit of fiddling, but it doesn't matter. Off here. Put in contact on that. You don't have to worry that the output will connect with this. I made provisions for that, that it won't happen. The hole is big enough, so this little screw won't touch the sides. So just fit it loosely for the moment to get everything into place. Those can touch with the heat sink. That doesn't matter. Let's have a look here. It's, yeah, that's up. Let's put them in. We have to see if it's if where we end up. Some brainstorming, so hopefully it pays off. That's a completely collector. There you go. And the next one. Yes. There you go. I don't think it will get that hot, so well, we will have some trials, see what I'll end up to, but where we end up, so I'll probably better that way, yeah, not better. I want to mount some strips down here, so I'll show you in a minute. I'll turn this over too. Now I'll tighten them down, see they are in the middle. That's fine. I will connect those two together later on, so we have only one connection, but you never know. Perhaps I need some more connections there, so it's nice to have them. Yeah, I insulated that one from that side, so this hole is big enough so that won't touch anything. We will check that in a minute. That's the output, this side, and this side is insulated. And you can see it is completely free here, it won't touch the metal at all. So I can put them in like that. And there you go. I put some washers on there and a nut, and that will be it. And then we can connect everything up. But before we have to do that, we I had to put in the transformer as well and drill those holes still. So we do that in a minute. Let's think of what's the best way to go. I think we have first start to wire this all up and then put it in, connect it up to the meters on the front. And as I said, we use the power supply here. On top, because it's out of sight at this moment. And then we have on the front, we have some control, and also on the end at the meter on the front of the device, we can see how much current and how much voltage comes out of there. So we can see how it works. Well, there are some pitfalls here and there, so this rectifier here could be a pitfall. It could be responsible for a voltage drop, and like it or not, this big transformer can be also a cause of voltage drop. But bear in mind, this is a very big core. It is about 100 watts too big. So there is some leeway in that core, so we have to see in practice where that leads. Yeah, I think that will be it. So let's check now if everything is alright, see if we have no false connections. Let's get that meter and I'll check. Here. Oh yeah. Well, the cheap meat of this one is, I bought that in Belgium, in Luxembourg actually, I bought that one. When I was up there, I saw in one of the shops in the stores there, and he was quite cheap, so I bought him. Oh, he served me well until now, so I have to buy myself a decent one sometimes, but we have to see. Now I'll start off on the heat sink, see if we have the collector connection. We have collector connection. Yeah. Now we don't have here. Well, the meter is at the lowest setting at 200 ohms. So, what have we here? We shouldn't have that, shouldn't we? Why is that? That shouldn't be on here. He's on there. How come? How come? This is insulated. It shouldn't be on there. He's on there though. Just undo this little screw. See what happened there. Okay. It shouldn't be. But I can. Oh. He should be on there, shouldn't he? Not to solve that. Nisko. Is it over there? That's still as dangerous, yeah. Just put them back in. Slide again. And it's back again, so that is something wrong. Have a look at that. Take it apart. Why is that? Let's have a good look at it. Why are you mucking me about? Let's have a look. Why are you mucking me about? Shouldn't have done that. You can see, sometimes you think, well, that will be enough and it's not enough. Take it off and have a look again. Let's have a look. Ah, there we go. I can see. Now you see it's not in the center, so I have to loosen all those screws up and move them over. Yeah. There goes the good work. Let's have a look. We can. No, not yet. Let's loosen them up a bit and put that in the middle. That's better. I should pay attention to that, shouldn't I? I can start all over again. Oh, there again, that's to do the measurements. That everything is okay. So, no surprises here. So we can tighten this up again. Yikes. That was nearly my hand. There we go. That was in the middle. At least I think. Let's try again, see what happens. This hole, I can make the hole bigger, but then again you lose the support. I don't want that, really. I want to lose the support there. Let's tighten on, then it should be okay. There we go. The moment of truth. Just tighten this down a bit. That's one. Just don't want to do it too tight, so I can move around if necessary. Now again, let's have a look. If he's free of that, he should be. Yes. No connection whatsoever. Yeah, that's how it should be. That is too low to measure. Okay. Fine. Let's tighten it up properly, and that will be it. Then check it once more to make sure we don't have any connection. See what happens. I'll test it once more, and then this should be alright. No, it's okay. So we're done with that. Now then, what I do next is make sure myself a schematic of something like that. That's the one I want. There we go. Make myself a little schematic up, so we have to brainstorm a little bit how we're going to do this, how we can connect that easily up, and also those transistors with for the Darlington, so that will be okay. I'll make myself a schematic, and then I'll come back to you and we proceed from there. And then we immediately start to checking out the function, if it functions or not. Put the 3 wires on here, on this spot, and make a provision onto the meters on the front. So, well, first, I'm going to make myself a schematic and take it from there. I have some ideas how I'm going to do that. See if it works out or not. I have to see. I'll see you in a moment. Well, there we are again. Well, that's some preliminary work. And that's some brainstorming about that power supply. An overvoltage power supply. I started several schematics, and this is about what I came up with. I don't know if you can see it, so I will check it. If you can see it. Well, that's about right, I suppose. Well, I'm not too worried about that schematic here. What I actually done is make 2 Darlington setups. Oh, that's my pencil. Oh, I have to do it without it, I suppose. Let's put my pencil somewhere. No, I don't know. No matter. I'll take my screwdriver. I make 2 Darlington setups here. And for a current limiting, I put another 2222 in there. So actually based upon this resistor here, which gives about 1.5 amp before he starts to influence the circuit. So actually this one that influences both of them. So I put also in an op amp in, LM358. I'm pretty sure that will function, but I'm not sure about the LM317. I hear already somebody saying why you use it as a voltage regulator. You can do it with a resistor and a Zener and a pot. Well, it's quite correct, but you call that single-minded, and I want to try this. So if it doesn't work, it doesn't work, and if it works, it works. So simple is it. Furthermore, this LM358 works up to 32 volts. I saw it in the, a data sheet. And you see I put a resistor in there, 6.8, just to be sure that the voltage is not too high, but then we're going to have to, that will work out of course on that, of the schematic, but just we have to try it and see how it goes. I put a 6.8 in here as well, so there will be some curve limiting from that, and the voltage drop of course. And I put a 15,000 microfarad electrolytic in there. So far so good. The only thing we have to do is now set the thing up and see where it leads us. I'm pretty sure this will work, and I'm quite confident that will work as well. I want to see what the voltage is here. I have on the transformer, I have 33 volts alternating, so if I put the bridge in, see what the voltage will be here in this point. So there's a word about the highest voltage, say 40 volts or something like that, then this will be too high for the 358. So that's why that is the reason why I put that 6.8 ohms in there. So this will affect the rest of the schematic, but we see what will happen when we do it. So so far so good. So that's so far as I get. It's a preliminary setup. So we'll see of how it works. I will do some work at this point here. This those 2 meters. I did some work already, and that turn it around for you. You can see I put a wire in there for plus, and I put the yellow wire into the terminal. Furthermore, I have also a 6.3 and a 12 volts supply for the filaments. I put that in as well. So the only thing we have to do now is get a gray wire, as I put in here, on there, feed it through, and then connect it up here, secure it on both points, and then we can turn over and see what's going on underneath. So let's do first that gray wire, what I have here. I did some work. Pre-drilled this for the transformer. I cut some wires on the transformer, so we're going to fit the transformer in there in a minute, and we have to do that first. The only thing that is actually not so nice is that it's very heavy then, and it's not easy to handle. But on the other side, if I've done all that, the only thing that is left is the wires to connect up on the switches and what the net concerns. So that won't be so much trouble. And we put some wires on the transformer. did some work on it as well. A couple of wires here, we join them up in a minute and then put them in there. So, and I'm afraid that will be nearly the end of part 5, because we go in the direction of 50 minutes, and I don't want to be that long with that video. We only about 50 minutes or 55 minutes, at the most 60. So we'll see how it goes. So we solder this wire and we put the solder in and get them fixed up. So, yes. Well, there's some brainstorming done yet. So how everything fits together. That's always the way how it goes with those self-built appliances. You never know where you're going to end up with. So that's the fun of it. But you never know how it will fit together, or it's always in the stars. So that's the way I'm working all day. So see how it goes and what comes out of it. And if it is not good, we have to correct it. It is that simple. And this doesn't want to solder. Now it will. Okay, there you go. Feed that through underneath. Let's see if we can pick him up. There we go. Nice and long. There we go. So we get some straps and secure it. I always recommend people to use those straps. It's not a luxury, you know. You get a lot of benefit of it, and you deliver nice work if you do it. There we go. This one. It looks nice when you look into it, and it makes it a little bit tidy. But the wires don't go all over the place. In the earlier days, I didn't do that. Well, sometimes I have to suffer the consequences of doing it. So. Now we're older and wiser, so we will do it. So that's that. Now we have all the wires in place for that. It's just the same as on that side, so it's similar to that. So I'll turn them over and show you how I have them on the bottom. You can see. Look. If we have that right. Yeah, that right. Now, what I've done here is to put in two diodes, two 3-amp diodes. I put in there in series with the amp meter. So, if we use the filaments, we can read the amps that is drawn. So, it goes up to 5 amps. So. So single rectifying, so that the meter will work. I wasn't able to get on the alternating current, so I had to improvise a little bit. As you can see, I put that in already for a bit. This is the plus that comes from the. Have a look here. There's the plus from the emissors. Yeah, with the two resistors, they will come up here. that's where I was going to, so that's that one. And we have here, we have the grey one. Yeah. You put that up here on this terminal, and if I find another black wire that is long enough, so look, another black wire here, is it long enough? I doubt it, but I can come across here, I don't like that really. Well, it wouldn't do any harm, so I can use the power. Can buy some more black wire, that's the last bit I got. So now it's New Year's Day. Oh, by the way, Happy New Year to you all. I will forget that. Yeah, that's what we have to do. Well, do some more explaining. So that is the negative, that will be the 6.3, and that will be the 12.6. So this goes to the bottom of the transformer, that will be a black bar, and those two, this one will be, those two will be yellow, and this will be red. So this will be 6.3, and this will be 12.6. So that's what we have to do. Now we have to get going with the transformer. So what I will do, I put this aside. And then get that ready. See, put some stuff up to the side to get some room. Well, you probably have the same problem on your workbench. You have it all cluttered, all sorts of stuff, and the things you would, what you want to do, you don't have any room. So that doesn't work really. But then every time it happens, and you don't learn, and every time it's the same. So, well. Probably sounds familiar to you, so well, that's things how things is. Now there's our famous transformer. Now we'll scratch the lacquer off and then we'll solder it all together. So I have here my wires. I pre-cut them already. And let's have a look. We'll turn them over. I'll do it the right way, otherwise it'll trouble. And that will be the black wire, that will be the yellow wire, and this will be the red wire. So that's quite easy, hopefully. So where's my knife? I'll scratch all those, the lacquer off. Well, no, it is not very interesting, but it also gives you an idea how long it takes to make an appliance like that. To give you a fair idea how what was all involved to make an appliance like this, like a regulated voltage supply. Well, there was a need for some time for one of the bench, so I finally decided after years and years and years of moaning about it and didn't have any, so I started over one. So. And there we go. I think there's some shrink on that to be sure that there's no shorts. If you didn't see my first video on transformers and you want to make a power supply, it's perhaps interesting for you to have a look at it. I recommend it to you. Maybe you will learn something. So it is not fair, not impossible at all to make a proper transformer. And you don't have to be worried that it won't work. It will work. And it will also work on 60 Hz, and in Europe is 50 Hz, but it doesn't matter. This core can handle that, so that's no problem. If you find a factory that actually makes transformers, and you know a guy there, or have a good relationship with, perhaps he can help you with the core and with the formers. and the wire as well, I suppose. Tell them a nice story of what a poor guy you are, and you have not much money, and so on and so on. No, I'm kidding. Yes, you tell them you're an amateur or whatever. And I told them that myself, so. And the officer was quite willing to help me. So I was able to buy some cords of different sizes and different formers, and the bolts and the nuts and the whole shebang that belongs to it. So that was rather nice of the guy. So I have good relations with him. So if I have a problem or whatever, I can just go contact him and he will help me. So I just have to make a drive of, say, 30, 40 miles to the factory, but it doesn't matter. It's a nice day out and then in the car, so there's a beautiful countryside. Now you have to see the benefit in anything, you know. It makes life pleasant. And life has been made miserable enough, as you know, with that virus, and I could do a nice rant about that, but I'm not going to start that. So, there you go. Ah, yeah. I don't think you are too keen on my rant, so. See, but the problem is if I start, I can't stop. That's the way it is. Let's see if I have my straight tubing, yeah, if I raise somewhere. There you go again. Run it up with it. Oh, there you go. Oh, and you never let it. Yeah, there you go. My string tubing. I get my hair dryer as well. Yes, that says. Well, don't tell the missus that I have a hair dryer. I will be prosecuted if I. I'm joking. Now then, let's see if we get this solder up. First, pre-solder that a bit. So. That life is hard, as you know. Well, here in Europe, we weren't allowed to go out at night. You had to stay in. We weren't allowed to do that. The police was patrolling, and if you was out there, you have to have a pretty good reason to be out there. Oh, I don't have to go anywhere, so it doesn't bother me. Life goes on. Oh, look, I do it right. No, I really am not too pleased what is going on, and we have to do it. It doesn't help anyway, so I can keep moaning about it, I suppose. There will be another day. Someday the truth will come on the air and fake news will stop. And then the people will know the truth, and that's the day I'm hoping for. Sooner or later, we will know the truth and what is going on. So, I think, well, mind you, it is a very deadly virus. You shouldn't underestimate it. It is a deadly virus. If you get it, it's not good for you. People get die and get very ill and sometimes have repercussions afterwards, so don't ever underestimate that virus. It is dangerous. There we go. I managed to stay out of it, so I have to do all the shopping and go to town, and now I stay out of crowded places. That's what I try to do, not to bunch up at the supermarket or anything, just to respect somebody's space. And it's good for her there, and it's good for me. But there again, so there are some things I have trouble with. See, I don't believe everything they tell me. Perhaps it's perhaps my age. Now I'm ranting again. It bothers me. See, people taking their freedom away. I don't like that. See, there was a Second World War been there. And a lot of those boys died for that freedom. That is what's bothering me. I'm ranting again. So that is bothering me. So people are died for that freedom. And you don't want that taken away. Those boys didn't die for nothing, if you know what I mean. And that's, I get very, very upset about that. I really do. I see here in Belgium, we have some burial places where those poor boys lay, paid the highest price. And sometimes I drive along there and think by myself, well, your boys, why did you die for this? But a lot of people such as don't care about that freedom. So, yeah. You can see I am troubled with it. I have trouble with it, I really do. And there are some people in this world, they don't care about it. Yeah. Well, I'm gonna shut up. Yeah, I was careful. I said I lose my video in a minute. Okay. I love doing this. Hook them up like that. Some people don't like to do this, but I do it. That makes it a bit more secure, certainly, than that transformer. I like to have that, so. Well, you would say, why don't you use the original wire and put some colored shrinking on it? Well, that would mean I have to go to the shop. And at the moment, they are not allowed to open. They shut every shop. So that makes it a bit more difficult to get your parts. And there we go. I'm just keep myself to the rules, protect myself. That's the main thing I'm going to do. Is protecting myself, me and my wife, and. Or my wife and me, as they say. I think that's the most important thing, so that I protect myself and my wife for that virus. That is a nasty virus. Oh. I didn't see things to see dead in my age, but I'm getting sure. That's very sham. Oh, there are probably people out there that don't like what I'm saying, some of the other stuff shit, isn't it? I'm sorry, excuse my French. I don't really give it to my two monkeys what they think. That won't fit. I'll have to do something about that. Let's see what. Get it to work. Squeeze it together a bit, hopefully. try it again. There we go. Well, and that one, where's my other cube? There it is. There we go. So hot this, I suppose. Should be okay. It won't come off anyway, so you can put the one I was in there. Right? No, I'm going to fix that with some bolts down, and I will do that off camera. So I'll see how it goes. I'll take this off. There you go. In a minute. Well, welcome back. I fixed the transformer. To be honest, it went well. I thought I would have some trouble getting them in, but it went quite easy, right to my liking. So he's in, and so the wires are long enough to get there. So. That's fine. So, later on we finish this all up top. First we're only doing underneath, and then we'll see later how it goes. Now we can connect up all our wires. Say starting off with that black wire. You can see they are too long. A better too long than too short. We cut them off. That's it. Okay. Put my soldering iron on again. The two are either transistor and voltage regulator. We'll put them back in later. So that was in the way. Actually, all those four bolts are just underneath that, so we have to remove that to get that one in. Well, what I'm saying, you know that. I will finish this up with you and connect this all up. And put that heatsink in with the transistors, and that will be the finish of part 5. And then we go on to part 6 and try to get things working. So that will be quite interesting. I think that would be nice. Well, as you can imagine by now, how much work this involves before you actually get to what you want. So we're gonna keep saying it. Just pre-salt all this a bit. Get my nose pliers. And get them all there. There we go. Just checking if there's how it should be. Could be better. Get some more salt. Make sure he's fixed good enough. So he doesn't get hot and come loose. And the other one. As you can see, you end up with a lot of wire. That's a shame, really. You always make your wires too long. No, I'll try to use them up later on other projects, so I'll save them. And then I try to use them up to otherwise it goes to waste. That would be a shame. That's a pretty salt on it as well. There we go. Constantly have to remind myself my fingers are not heat resistant. I burnt myself severely, so I got it back stupidly. I learned from that, and sometimes I'm still doing the same thing again. So well, you won't believe it, but our video is already over an hour. Just because I let you in on all the details, and even then I have to cut corners. That will go beyond what I want. I just like to show you what is involved in making an appliance like that. We're not in the test phase yet, so there we go. Put a nice rubber around it. And you're right there. Near to the finish of this part. There we go. That's a minute. That's nice. Now, fix this one up. I pre-soldered the terminal because I noticed by the first one that wasn't very easy to solder it, so I took it off and I had to go with it with the Dremel. So got the top layer off and then wood solder. So Well, actually, this Dremel going to service later on with testing the gear. So he draws normally when he's running 1.5 amp, something like that. And when you hold on to him, he goes up to 3 amps, so even more. So let's see if everything works. That will be nice, and we can see it on both displays. So what's going on? So that looks rather nice. So that's all of this. And before we connect up the transformer, we'll use the other power supply to test the circuit. So we have the front we can test and see, and the end result we can see it as well. So that looks nice. See if something goes wrong, do some measurements and take it from there. I'm looking forward to that one. There we go. Get our soldering done. Okay, takes a lot of solder. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'll make sure this is done properly. I don't want any surprises. Well, let's see. First, I want to try to go around the corner here and see if we can connect it up somehow. Failing that, we can always can go on there with my tool, with this, with my cutting tool, and cut a little corner out of there and hook it over. So. We'll see how it goes. Right. Now, I can put this back. Put that in. The separation. So, yep. That's okay. Put him in. Come on then, where are you? In there. The washer up there. Let's have a look. Where's the rest? Mm-hmm. And there he is. I have to Dremel those bolts. They are too long. And they will be in the way. So. What I'll do now is tighten them down. Put up the rest. Put that up with the rest. Or something. Where's the other one? See, too much rubbish on the table, isn't it? You can't find things anymore. So look in here. No. I think I should whistle at it, but hey, my pencil. Let's have a look. Find another one. That will reappear someday. I'll clear up. There we go. I have to get some more of them. Can't do that now. Can't get to the market, so it is closed. He says sarcastically. I'm really cheesed with it, all this. But politicians are politicians. No, shut up. Don't go further than that. Tighten this in. I'll put one on top of it and you can flex this off. I'll do it again. Guys, if you like my video, then give me a thumbs up. And if you don't like my video, say nothing. So, well, it will make amends sometimes. So, yeah, it would be nice if you tell me what you like. Give some comments. I see from there. There you go, guys. So far, so good. That's as far as this part goes, and we'll shut them down, and we start a new video with the rest of it. So I'll see you later.